So what we are is a vintage arcade, or I would say mostly vintage arcade. We're a pay for entry arcade where everything is on free play once you get in. At this location, we have right now about 90 games up and running, and we've only been in business at this spot for about 4 months, so we're just kind of getting rolling on this. We expect to have upwards of about 140, 150 games when it's all said and done.
Hey, it's Dave once again here from Retro Injection with Riven. To the Game Preserve. This is the NASA location. Yesterday we were at the Sawdust Road location here in Texas. Today we're at NASA. This is the big one. This is the motherload of arcades. We're very excited to be here. It's actually over there. You can't see it from here, but I wanted to get the rig in there and show you how brave we are driving this thing all the way from New York. We haven't had a single problem with it except one stall. So it's in a small bathroom. So here we are. We're getting ready to rock. Let's check it out. Square footage wise, this is going to be one of the biggest arcades I've ever been in. This is a relatively new location. I spoke with the owner, Rusty, and he said that they're getting new stuff in all the time. So here we are, this is it. I love the murals. That's very old school 80s arcade. DJ booth. Looks like a UFO. How cool is that?
They've got their movie screen there that looks like a CRT. If you can see that. That's fantastic.
Great attention to detail here. And the mural just keeps wrapping around. We've got a stage here for live music. These are all
either storage or it looks like projects, actually. Got some out-of-order signs here. But let's take a look around just for completion's sake. This is all stuff that could go on the floor at some point. That's their party room in there. We'll take a look at that when we go around. Down here in the aisles, we've got looks like excavators. We've got missile commands, world blasted far drive, and let's take a look down here. What the heck? CDs every day. That's awesome. Maybe all the moment here is a laser in this game. This is actually the game that all the Domino Man machines are converted from. This is not a hot seller, so they converted a lot of them, most of them I would dare say, into Domino Man machines. And even that's pretty rare, so I've never actually seen one of these in person before. That's incredible. This is a really fun game. I grew up playing this in college. I didn't grow up playing it in college, but I did play this quite a bit in college. Our college arcade had a Pac-Mania, and man, I put a lot of time on that machine. Just a lot of fun pseudo 3D Pac-Man. You can jump over the ghost. It's awesome. Check out the site retroinjection.com for a little blurb on Pac-Mania within my Pac-Man Pac-Land preview for the TurboGrafx 16. Don't believe I've ever seen an Enduro racer in the wild. That's pretty great. Played a lot of that on the Master System. It's got the handlebars here, kind of like Atari's Paperboy would have. Planties and a shoes, Atari shoes, horseshoe game. Showcase cat here, or timeout. We used to have Mortal Kombat 3 on that. Classic Taito elevator action. Grew up with that in our skating rink in Pittsburgh. Cocktail Frogger here. And another Pump It Up. They had one of these at their Sawdust Road location. I love the music here. Hopefully YouTube won't give us any copyright nonsense for this. Mm-hmm. can't go wrong with a Mario pinball. That'll be exciting to have that on the floor. My wife is a big Mario fan. She's the one behind the camera. Hi, hi. So cool. Spy Hunter plays the Peter Gunn theme. It's absolutely the best part of the game. Among them being the highly controversial Chiller. Crossbow was another one of their shooters. First time I've seen one of those in the wild. This is their party room here. You can see the giant quarter up there going into the coin slot. I love the mismatched inserts there, just like you would find on an old game. This is their private party room in here. Oh, if we can kind of sneak in there. Looks like we can kind of sneak in. Let's take a look. We probably shouldn't be doing this, but I highly doubt we'll get in trouble. So this is very spacious in here. And of course, this lights up the coin return from the outside. That's the beauty of this. Check this out. That is a stroke of genius right there. I love that. Mario and Princess Peach there for men and women, and it's even in pixelated font on there. That's incredible. What a great addition. So that's that. Zybox there, one of the most distinctive cabinets of all time. It's really hard to convert to anything. But that didn't stop me from trying. Here on the bottom pulls right out where you can swap out any PCB you want. Assuming it's jam, of course. These banners all over the place. Of course, these are the pinball titles here. Apollo 13, very appropriate, being the NASA location. And Black Hole here. This is like a huge pinball machine lounge. I don't know if you can see the entirety of this, but if you were to take a look at it from like over here, you'd see it.
On your mark. Get that.
See, this is like a giant pinball machine in here. We've got the plunger here. We've got the button over here. Designed to look like a black hole there. You've got the back glass there. Flippers here. How awesome is that? We got a Mario mural there. I love that. That's my favorite part of the whole place, is that Mario mural. Let's take a look and see what we got down this side. Love those track and field cocktails. This one does not have the pencil guards put on. Back in the day, kids would take a pencil and use it to accentuate the movement between the run buttons. So operators install these little ridged pieces that went over the buttons so you couldn't use a pencil and cheat. Yeah. Love Data East. I'm a huge Data East fan. These cabinets are fantastic. I love the curved marquees. Very distinctive.
What, your mark?
Had a couple of these in my day. Still have a Data East cabinet. I've got a Vapor Trail. Yep. Nice archive. Not currently functional, apparently, but man, these Universal cabinets are so sweet. Love that curvature. Love the backlit artwork there. Man, every day I kick myself. I sold my Mr. Do years ago. I had a dedicated Mr. Do, and I really miss that. Pac-Land right here, look at that. Fantastic, dedicated Pac-Land. Of course, that's in the, it's a Professor Pac-Man conversion. They all are. Every dedicated Pac-Land is a conversion of Professor Pac-Man. An absolute bomb of a title, Professor Pac-Man. Love Pac-Man, fun game. Never seen a lock and chase in the wild before. It's fantastic. I just thought these afterburner uprights were a nice compromise if you didn't have room for a cockpit. Still the same motif. It's got a great look to it. Definitely stands out in a lineup. This is actually the first one-on-one fighting game ever, created the entire fighting game genre. Most people know this game from Bloodsport, the Jean-Claude Van Damme movie. I miss my gyros too. Bought a waterlogged gyro several years back for $90 and ended up not really being salvageable. I remember there being a huge crowd for this game back here. Back at the timeout I worked at. Eventually, when I was a kid. I mentioned it in my last video. I grew up in a timeout. Check out my documentary, Timeout, History of a Small Town Arcade, right here on YouTube. Terminator 2 Judgment Day was an absolutely stellar game. You used to have a line of kids waiting to play it. This place is so great. Tons of room. Have your party here. It's Game Preserve. Game Preserve NASA right here in Texas. Check it out. It's great. I'm gonna be here for a while. We'll see you later.